What do you think about Malle Motoclass? Because one of our guy, Lithuanian guy, he is leading the race right now. So what do you think about it? Maybe you're thinking someday in the future?
No. No, that class is not for me. Them guys are a different breed. It's amazing what those guys can do.
Акумулятору Galasso Still. Meilė HD pristato vokiškos kokybės pastiprintos konstrukcijos važiuoklės dalis.
Nice to meet you. We are a media team from Lithuania. I go to Dakar.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good to be here and yeah, thanks for having me. Finally, we got a rest day, so yeah, this always seems to be the challenging part to get here is in the best of shape that you can. No injuries to yourself, no damage to the bike. So it's, good to get a day off and felt weird sleeping in this morning. So all in all, we're trying to recharge the batteries and get ready for day 7 and get into it full gas from there.
So you enjoyed this morning because it was different?
Yeah, 100%. I definitely enjoyed a nice sleep in. So got breakfast in bed, I got the front bunk of the camper and the table's right there, so I had breakfast there this morning, so it wasn't like a long liaison ride in the freezing cold and waiting for breakfast until we got to the truck, so it was, cannot complain to have a good sleep in.
So we are already in the halfway, can you go through the last 6 stages of the Dakar 2021?
It's a difficult one to describe and put into one piece. I nearly need a book to write about it. So it's just been like up and down. It's been a yo-yo effect and every day is just a new challenge and a new day. So it's definitely making it really difficult to make a good strategy and a good plan to get yourself in good places for the next day's stages. And so honestly, I think the top 10 is like basically around 12-13 minutes apart or something. So normally by rest day, we normally have a bit of a gap and you can start to kind of situate yourself where you want to be and kind of know the result that may be coming your way. But at the moment, we're in a massive big fight and it doesn't seem to be getting any easier.
Some competitors say that this year Dakar is way more like interesting, more beautiful stages. What do you think about it?
In some ways, yes, 100%. They've made some good stages this rally, but the good ones are the ones you make no mistakes. Then the ones that you've seen, I think, was day 5 that we were all lost and going backwards and all over the place. They're the days that are super frustrating and quite annoying to get through, but you just need to try and fix and minimize those mistakes as quickly as possible and then keep charging on. And at the moment, we're leading at the halfway point, but honestly, like I say, it really doesn't mean nothing at the moment. So there's still plenty of racing to go and anything can happen. So we have no room for error at the moment.
From the navigation point of view, is it harder than the last year?
Yeah, for sure. They've definitely changed the roadbooks around a lot this year to try and make it a little bit more technical for us. So I think that's why you've seen us, day 5, just going every which direction bar the right direction for us. So when you see the cars that have got basically a full-time navigator with them and they're going backwards and all over the place trying to search for things, you know it's a really tough day. So we're trying to do all this by ourselves. So it's really difficult, but we're enjoying the challenge and we're having fun.
This year you have a limitation of 6 tires during the whole Dakar. Does it compromise your driving style?
A little bit, yes, for sure. So when you get into the stones and the rocks and everything, you're trying to preserve the tire as much as you can, so you're not like hard on the throttle and trying to tear the tire apart. But when it gets into a full sand stage, you're trying to make up that bit of time you lost in the stones and trying to go full gas and wide open. So in one way, yes, it's slowed us down in one area, but I think in another way, it's made us try and go faster in another. So it's it's a rule there that we've all got to deal with, and that's just how it is. And at the moment, our tyres are looking really good for the rally. We're at the halfway mark, and I think we still have three new tyres and one or two that's still in a pretty good condition. So, yeah, we can't complain, and just hopefully it pans out in our favour.
So in the last stages, you are going to destroy them?
It depends on what position we're in, I think. So I think no matter what, we're going to destroy tyres. But if, yeah, I've got a 2-minute lead, or I'm 2 minutes down, I really do feel sorry for the bike, because it's going to get an absolute flogging on the last day. So we'll see. Hopefully we have a little bit of a buffer, but like I say, at the moment the competition is really tight. Everyone's picked it up, I think, another two levels, and there's more than one. So it's, yeah, we just got to try and, like I say, minimize their mistakes and get through each day.
What do you think about Malle Motoclass? Because one of our guy, Lithuanian guy, he is leading the race right now. So what do you think about it? Maybe you're thinking someday in the future?
No, that class is not for me. Them guys are a different breed. So honestly, it's amazing what those guys can do. And yeah, okay, they look at us, what we're doing at the front, and our times and our speeds. But as you can see behind us, we have mechanics that look after all the bikes and keep everything in tip-top shape and maintained for us. And we have a crew of people around us trying to help make sure we've got gear and everything organized. And these guys, they do everything by themselves and get no time for rest. And I think some of the stages, they're getting back in at night and riding at night. So yeah, I take my hat off to them. I honestly don't ever see myself entering that class. It's too much for me.
The first thing you're going to do after the Dakar, when you come back home, maybe you're going on a holiday, or?
I would love to go on a holiday. At the moment, with all these COVID rules and stuff in, it's quite hard for me to get back home to Australia. So I don't fly home until the 30th of January. So I've got basically, 12, 15 days that I'm going to spend in Dubai. So depending on the result here at Dakar, it might be a quiet one. But if the result's good, then I would say that it might be a few outrageous parties in Dubai and celebrate a little bit. So we'll wait and see.
We have a big community of Dakar fans in Lithuania. Like, we have 7 competitors this year in different categories.
Awesome.
What you can say to them?
Guys, it's stoked to have you guys here. It's to have a small group of people that you know and you can go and talk to, and they're from your home country. It's a really special feeling. But guys, keep charging on, enjoy the race, be safe. We'll see you at the finish line, and unfortunately we won't be sharing any or cheersing to any beers here, but we will hopefully see you at the finish line and enjoy the race. So keep at it.
Thank you very much.
No worries at all. Cheers, boys.